from Pat?
First off, congrats to Sam Schweitzke and staff and the Princeton Tigers. They're having a phenomenal year for them. Hopefully they do some damage in the next round. I just thought tonight I couldn't have been more proud of our guys. If you would have said to me, hey, we'll give you, if you would have said to me in February, we'll give you game five, 8-8 in the EIVA championships, I would have jumped on it. This team has been through so much this year with injuries, with different lineups, and their resiliency and their desire to cultivate a true team atmosphere, I think has really paid off for us, certainly this week, and I think this is really just the beginnings for this team. I think there's, the future looks really bright.
Okay, Gordon, I guess, what were you telling your guys as you're heading to this set?
Just compete, just have fun. I mean, Gordon, this may be the most fun match I've ever had on the bench. Because you sat there, they were locked in to what we wanted to do strategically. They certainly were locked in competitively. And more than that, you looked out and you saw a team out there. You didn't see six individuals. You saw a team. And there really wasn't a whole lot that Colin, Ryan, or Dylan and I had to add or change. They were playing at a level that we had hoped that we could have gotten them to earlier in the year, but they got to it. And it was fun to watch. And we just kept saying, you know, we kept reiterating some of the top tenets we had in the scouting report, just so they made sure that they were on board with it. It was really a match that I thought was fairly easy to coach. It was also a match that it's a shame that somebody had to lose. We just ran out of points.
And for both of you guys, what was it like being on the court and being involved in a match like that that was so tight all the way to the end?
I mean, insane. I've been in like a lot of those matches, but like it being my last year, you know, it being that close, that competitive was just like amazing. Looking back on it, I feel like I can't even remember half the stuff that happened, so I was so excited the whole time, shouting. So yeah, just like amazing.
I'd have the same thing as him in regards to really not remembering like too many specific points. I mean, it was just a super fun match playing all around.
And just to clarify, Grace and Gianna, that was Matt McLaren who spoke first, followed by Brett Wildman, okay?
Thank you.
Brett, and just how are you feeling out there? It seemed like you and George were just going, you know, hammer back and forth. And you just, was it feeling like you had to do everything to match him?
I know.
At least
I was looking at Kevin. Of course.
Pat was not on the court.
Thankfully.
No, I mean, it never really felt like we were going back and forth because we have so many guys on our team who do great things. I mean, literally everyone from our center, Cole, both middles, Jason and Candy, both outsides, obviously, Steve and Henry, and Barrows, the ones that in there, and certain sides, everyone. But, like, they provide all those opportunities for me to succeed, for one another to succeed. It's a team effort. We don't really take pride in trying to have like a 1v1 guy situation.
I guess for both of you, that kind of atmosphere with all this team has been through this year, just everything that you've worked so hard for, what did it mean to culminate in a match that was an instant classic?
Wait, you said
it
like
that. Yeah, to have a match like that, an instant classic, after everything that you've gone through this year, like in your career, to have it culminate in that, how special was that? What do you think about this team?
I mean, I couldn't be prouder of like where we came with all these young guys from starting at that's pretty special. To go out in like a match like that where we're just battling out and we gave everything, we did not back off at all. It was amazing. I couldn't ask to go out any other way.
Pat, there were several points where you had five first-year guys and four freshmen. How do you think they handled those situations?
Today was the culmination of what they were working for all year long. We had them up there all year long, and they were in a great spot, I thought. It more so with understanding what it means to compete at this level. They're going to get better as volleyball players, but if they use this as the springboard for how they compete over the next 3 or 4 years, Rec Hall is going to be jumping. We're going to have a lot of fun in that gym.
Okay, Grace and Gianna, I have time for about 3 or 4 questions, okay?
Okay. Gianna, you did two altitude?
Yeah, perfect.
All right, go first. Okay, please. Tell us, this is for you, and it's Steve or Brett want to chime in and answer it.
Well, I think that one of the things that we had mentioned here is how competitive we were. You know, Steve and Brett have talked about what this team has battled through, resiliency. I think this is a great example for our team to understand how important culture is, to understand how to get people on the same page. And I think it's a step in the right direction for us. It's a big step, but I think with the leadership that Steve and Lee and Frank and some of the other fourth-year guys have had, it sets a real good tone for what's going to start next week for us. And we start looking at next year, and these guys have to make a commitment over the summer when nobody's watching to get themselves better. And with the culture that's being established here has been pushed by the upperclassmen. I fully expect that to happen.
To you, Coach Ennis, what would you say that the players can take away from this tournament season, the one that will be returning for next season?
Pretty much the same thing.
I mean, I can chime in what we'll take away. I mean, we'll miss the seniors like no other. All the younger guys, everyone this year, I've learned so much from them. Not even from volleyball, but life in general. But I think that, I don't know, I looked at Fisher after, and we're kind of like, this isn't going to happen again. I think that we'll take away that feeling, and then over the next 3 years, I don't think that this will happen again.
Coach, not too sure if you would, but if anything was to be done differently tonight, what would that be?
Nothing. Nothing. We're 15-13 in game five. I'm not sure that there was outside of game three, there was never a lead that we didn't overcome. I wouldn't have done anything differently. These guys just competed their butts off.
Okay, I'm
going to
ask one more question. This turns to Steve and Brett. You guys said like this match was so special for you guys. This center was, one of the biggest matches for you guys. What about this match in particular made it so special for both of you?
Well, for me, it's my last match, so that's pretty special. Also, it's the IBA championship that makes it special. And we just went out there and battled, and it was crazy, exciting, so that also made it special for me.
Yeah, I think just the overall energy that was brought and the camaraderie of all of us playing together and literally loving, enjoying every moment on the court playing with each other, we're kind of taking that away.
Okay, thank you, YouTube.